Hi everybody, this is Coach Christy from CrossFit Mokena bringing to you our workout for Wednesday, April 15th, 2020 called Hump Day. Why am I wearing an O2 shirt? Just a reminder that both Formula O2 and Killcliff are offering amazing deals right now. If you guys use code RECOVERY210, so RECOVERY210, Formula O2 is giving 50% off plus free shipping to anyone who uses that code, and Killcliff is giving 10% off to anyone who uses that code. So again, that code is RECOVERY210, RECOVERY210. So what is our warm up today? First, we're gonna come down to the floor and we're gonna do some scorpions and eagles and a couch stretch and a psoas stretch to get some stretching in. The scorpions are gonna stretch out our quads as well as our low back. Eagles are gonna stretch out our glutes and our hamstrings. The couch stretch is going to do our quads, and the psoas is for our hip flexors. After we're done stretching, we're going to then do 10 box jumps or step ups. Reminder, our member Kelly Sweeney is building boxes if you would like a box. We're then going to do 10 alternating kettlebell or dumbbell snatches and then go out for a 200 meter run, which is an eighth of a mile. Our strength is a 12 minute EMOM, every minute on the minute for 12 minutes. On the even, we're going to do a very challenging 30 second hollow rock hold. And then on the odd, you have some options. We can do 8 knee hops or 20 air squats. Knee hops are very, very challenging. So if we are unable to do those, we can do air squats instead. Our workout today is 4 rounds for time. So you're going to go through this list in green 4 times. We're going to start with a 200 meter run. For those of you that aren't going outside, if you're hopping on a rower, it is a 250 meter row. If you are hopping on a bike, whether it be stationary or outside, we double that distance and it is 400 meters. Regardless though, for the run outside or a treadmill, it's still 200 meters, which is an eighth of a mile. Then we're gonna do 20 alternating kettlebell or dumbbell snatches, which would mean 10 on each arm. We're then gonna make those box jumps or step ups a little more challenging. We're gonna do burpee box jumps or step ups. Then 20 single arm kettlebell or dumbbell push press, 10 on each side. For those of you with the barbell at home, feel free to sub in the barbell for both the snatches and the push press. Our post wad then is 3 rounds. We're gonna do 12 V-ups followed by 8 Jane Fondas. Those of you who know who Jane Fonda is, she's a fantastic aerobics instructor. And then we're gonna do a 30 second push-up plank. CrossFit Mokena members, you know if you do the post wad, you get that super awesome star next to your name. So really quick, one more time, let's go over that code. It is RECOVERY210. So that code is going to save you 50% off of O2 as well as getting you free shipping, and it'll save you 10% off Killcliff. So let's go ahead and start demoing our movements. For both the scorpions and the eagles, we're gonna lay down flat on the floor with our arms in a T. For the scorpion, I'm gonna be on my stomach and my chest. So I'm gonna lay face down, hands are wide, my legs are the tail of the scorpion. So I'm gonna rotate, trying to get my foot up towards my hand and come back down. And then rotate, getting my foot up towards my hand and then down. These should not be rushed, take your time. That was 2, we're gonna do 10 total. Then we're gonna flip over and do 10 eagles. Same thing, hands in a T, but now I'm on my back. To stretch out my glutes and my hamstrings, again, I bring my foot up to my hands. This would be 1, and then I come back down. And then I switch to the other side. This would be 2, hold it as long as you need, and then come back down. Then we're gonna do a 30 second couch stretch on each leg. I'm gonna come up to the wall, I'm gonna get my shin along the wall and then bring my other leg out in front of me. For many of us, this might be as far as we can stretch, and that's okay. If you can, we're gonna come back up towards the wall. So this is stretching the right quad. I'm gonna hold it for 30 seconds on this side and then switch 30 seconds on the other. That psoas. Your psoas is a muscle that starts at your tailbone and comes around the front of your hip flexors. To stretch out the psoas, we're just going to go into a lunge position, and I'm going to push my hips down and forward into the floor. So I'm currently stretching the right psoas, or my hip flexors. If you want to intensify that stretch, we can absolutely lean backwards. So we want to hold that for 30 seconds on each side, pushing the hips down and into the floor. Once we're done stretching, we're gonna go into the next part of our warm-up. We have box jump, snatches, and a run. I'm going to demo step-ups. For those of you with boxes though, it's a 2-foot takeoff, tiny little dip, swing those arms for momentum. Once we get on top of the box, make sure we come to full hip extension at the top. If you don't have a box, a chair or your stairs are absolutely acceptable. Those of you doing the stairs, we want to go up 2 steps. But for those step-ups, once I get on top, same thing as the box jump, full hip extension at the top. So we're going to do 10 box jumps or 10 step-ups. For those snatches, you can use a kettlebell or a dumbbell. I'm going to straddle the kettlebell or dumbbell. It's one motion from the floor overhead. In super slow motion, I do a deadlift, I'm gonna shrug, bring that elbow high, and dip to receive overhead. Alternating, I'm then gonna go to the other arm. Again, super slow motion, I deadlift, I shrug, high elbow, and dip to receive overhead. So a little more quickly, starting from the floor, bring that kettlebell or dumbbell right up overhead. After the snatches, we're then gonna go into a 200 meter run, which again is 1/8 of a mile. For those of you rowing, it is 250 meters. And for those of you on a bike, we are doubling the distance and it is 400 meters. From there, we're gonna go into our strength. Every minute on the minute for 12 minutes. On the even, 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10, we're gonna do a very challenging hollow rock hold. I'm gonna lay on the floor, and I'm gonna try to have my upper body and lower body elevated at the same time. My goal is to have my hands up by my biceps up by my ears. So lower body and upper body off the floor at the same time, low back pushed into the floor. So I wanna hold that for 30 seconds. On the odd minutes, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, I'm gonna do some knee hops. What I'm doing is I'm sitting flat on the floor. I need to get explosive power from my hips. I'm going to jump and land in a squat position. So down on the floor, swing the arms for momentum, land on the feet, and stand. That would be 1. All the way down, that would be 2. And then back down. If we can't do those, we're gonna do air squats instead. Feet underneath my shoulders, push back to get my weight in my heels, and fight to get down below parallel. After our strength, our workout today, hump day, 4 rounds for time. We're gonna either head back outside on that 200 meter run or a 250 meter row or a 400 meter bike, lots of options. After that, we're gonna do 20 of those snatches. So 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way up to 20. Then we're gonna make our box jumps a little bit more challenging. Rather than just a regular box jump, or rather than just the regular step up, we're adding a burpee before that movement. So chest and thighs to the floor, and then into that step up, full hip extension. Again, chest and thighs to the floor, and then into our step up, full hip extension at the top. So 15 burpee box jumps or 15 burpee step ups. Then we're gonna do 20 single arm kettlebell or dumbbell push press. The push press is when the kettlebell starts in the front rack position or dumbbell. I dip and press, dip and press, dip and press. Same thing on the other side, but from another angle. Tiny dip, keeping my weight in my heels, torso tall, press right up overhead. As it mentions, you can do these things with a barbell. For those snatches, feet are narrow, hands are wide. What I'm gonna do is a deadlift first till I hit full hip extension. Same thing, I'm gonna shrug, high elbow, and dip to receive overhead. From another angle, back is flat, hips and shoulders rise at the same time, full hip extension, shrug, high elbow, and dip to receive overhead. For the push press, hands are right outside of the shoulders. I'm gonna do a tiny dip and press, tiny dip and press. Once I'm at the top, I wanna make sure my biceps are right by my ears. After you complete that list 4 times, take a look at the clock and that's your score. If you would like a super cool star next to your name, there is a post WOD today. The post WOD is 3 rounds total. We're gonna start with 12 V-ups. For that V-up, upper body and lower body come off the floor at the same time, and we're trying to make contact of our hands with our shoes. If we can't do those, we can keep our hands on the floor and just bring our knees into our chest. Now, what's our good old school Jane Fonda? We're gonna be on our side. You don't want to be all the way up on your hip. You wanna come back a little and sit on that glute. And then we're gonna lift our legs. If we really wanna make it like Jane Fonda, our upper body and lower body come off the floor at the same time, and our elbow and our knee make contact. You're gonna do 8 of those on each side of the body. And then we're gonna finish with a 30-second push-up plank, hands underneath the shoulders, keeping that core nice and tight, and we're gonna hold this for 30 seconds. Once you finish that 3 times, let me know and you get a star next to your name. So don't forget guys, Recovery 210, Recovery 210 is gonna save you 50% and get you free shipping on O2, and we'll save you 10% off Killcliff. Good luck, everybody.